The first-class devotional service is known by one's tendency to be fully engaged in Krishna consciousness, serving the Lord favorably, not unfavorably. Anukul pratikul. Anukullasya sankalpa. Or pratikullam vivarjana. Bhakti means we should simply accept what is favorable to Krishna. What is not favorable to Krishna, that we shall not accept. Just like Arjuna, in the beginning, he declined to fight. He was thinking favorable to his own senses, that if I kill my brother, grandfather, nephews, those who are on the other side, they have come to fight with me, so I can kill them. I can own victory over them. But what is the profit? If my relatives, friends and all others die, then what is the use of my becoming victorious? That was it. That means he was thinking in his favor. Krishna wanted that you must fight. You are a Kshatriya. It is your duty to fight. You are my friend. If you go away, fly away from this battlefield, what people will say that Krishna's friend has gone. So this is not good. So when he could not be convinced, then Krishna had to speak the whole Bhagavad Gita. Then after hearing Bhagavad Gita, Krishna inquired from Arjuna, what is your decision now? Are you going to fight or not? Arjuna said, yes, my illusion is over. Nashto moha sthitilam tat prasadena madhusudana. So kari seva jananta. Yes, I shall fight. So this is favorable to Krishna. So we have to see what is favorable to Krishna. Not sense gratification, not favorable to me, or to my country, or to my society. No self-interest, only Krishna's interest. So by fighting, Arjuna became a great devotee. Bhaktorsi, Priyosine, Krishna certified that you are my greatest devotee. You are my very confidential friend. But what did he do? He did not read Vedanta philosophy. He was a grihastha, a king, engaged in fighting. He knew how to fight only. He did not know. What is Vedanta philosophy? But still, he became a great devotee of Krishna, Bhaktoshi. So what is the criterion? The criterion is that he fought favorably, he did favorably to Krishna consciousness. That is described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. What is the difference between kama and lust and love. Kama and prema. Prema is love and kama is lust. It appears similar. In the material world, lust is going on in the name of love. A boy loves a girl, a girl loves a boy. But actually, the boy also wants sense gratification. And the girls also want sense gratification. That is not love. As soon as there is any difficulty and sense gratification, immediately there is divorce. So there is no love. There is only lust. In the material world, there is no love. That's why the author of Chaitanya Charitamrita, He has distinguished between love and lust. He said, Atmendriya Tripti Mancha Tar Nam Kam. When you want to satisfy your senses, that is called lust. Krishnendriya Tripti Mancha Dhare Prem Nam. When you want to satisfy the senses of Krishna, oh, that is love. Just like Arjuna. In the beginning, he wanted to satisfy his own senses. I shall not fight, because if the other party, my brothers and grandfathers, they leave, I shall be happy. So that is calm, that is not prayer. But when he agreed to fight, because Krishna wanted it, nimitta matra bhavasambha sachi. So, that is prayer. So, Krishna prayer can be executed in so many ways. Simply, Krishna should be satisfied. That is prayer. That is Krishna consciousness. So, at the present moment, Krishna, in the Bhagavad Gita, wanted Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. Krishna wanted Arjuna. Arjuna means everyone. That they should surrender to Krishna and be engaged in the service of Krishna. So people, Krishna, when you speak of Krishna, means God, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So this Krishna consciousness movement is propagating. To serve Krishna. When Krishna was present, he demanded that you surrender unto me, and we are preaching, you surrender unto Krishna. What is the difference? There is no difference. So, the same thing, what was spoken 5,000 years ago by Krishna personally, we Krishna conscious man, because we are known in the world as Hare Krishna people. They write in the newspaper, the Hare Krishna people. So, our preaching is the same. We don't change. We present therefore Bhagavad Gita as it is. Krishna says that everyone should surrender unto him. We are preaching the same philosophy, that you surrender to Krishna. Krishna says, Manvana bhavamad bhakta madhyaji mag namaskuru. We say the same thing. We ask everyone that you become a devotee of Krishna, you think of Krishna constantly, you worship Krishna, you offer your obeisances unto Krishna. So this is parable. If we preach what Krishna said 5,000 years ago, that is parable. That is Krishna consciousness. To act in favor of Krishna means Krishna consciousness movement. One.
Purport is that one may also be in Krishna consciousness unfavorably, but that cannot be counted as pure devotional service. Pure devotional service should be free from the desire for any material benefit or for sense gratification, as these desires are cultivated through fruitive activities and philosophical speculation.
Yes. Sense gratification, as I was explaining infinitely before, Chaitanya Chaitamrita Kar says, Bhukti Mukti Siddhi Kami Shakoli Asant. Bhukti. Bhukti means karmis. They want sense enjoyment. So long they live here in this body, they enjoy their senses to the topmost, and they make provision for the next life to be elevated in the heavenly planet, to enjoy in the Nandan Kanan with the demigods. More standard of living, enjoyment, more opulent. That is the desire of the karmis. Gyanis, they say, Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya. This world is false. There is no enjoyment, actual enjoyment, to merge into the existence of Brahma. So that is also a subtle sense enjoyment. Leave this world and enter into Brahma, then you feel happy.